right, ShawTellFightHype.com here with Dennis Duglin, Brick City.
It was good.
Dennis, man, you sparred with Sergey Kovalev for this camp, is that right?
Yes, sir.
Can you give us the update?
Before I get into it, let me say rest in peace to Patrick Day, man. Like, I want to say that every time because I want to keep that going, man. Like, he's a great dude. So rest in peace to Patrick Day. And shout out to all his family and friends and everything like that. I'm going to Kovalev now. Yes, I was in camp at Kovalev. That was a great experience for me because I did the whole thing orthodox. As you guys know, if you know me, I'm southpaw. So, and I only sparred Sean Porter orthodox. That was my first time sparring somebody right-handed, and he's bigger than me, and he's good. I mean, he's the best. So that was tough. So it's safe to say that he got the better of every session, 100%. He definitely did. But I was able to land some stuff. I was able to see his strengths and weaknesses. I think, like everyone knows, his jab is amazing. He had a great jab. I was telling you earlier,
Does it feel like a right hand almost, his jab?
Yeah.
Is it? Okay.
Another thing he does really well, he punches the arms and stuff like that. I guess that's like a European kind of thing where I have my hands up, he's beating my arms up. I never really thought that was effective. But out there, like after three rounds of that, like, damn, I can't lift my arm up. Like, so I thought that was really effective. He's good, man. Like, he's real good. Like I said, again, it was really hard for me to gauge as an orthodox fighter. The last day I switched and I went southward just because I know I can't get fired. So I switched and I did really well. But that came from a bunch of sessions of me sparring him. So I know what he could bring to the table. But he never sparred me southward, so he didn't know what I was going to do. So it's hard to gauge. I did it the last round, so he didn't have time to make any adjustments. So I don't know. But I think it's a great fight. I think he's good. He trains hard. But he has been looking sharp. They're working on the right things, I think, stylistically for Canelo. So I think it's going to come down to the win, man. As long as he's able to keep that shape for 12 rounds. And Canelo, we'll see how that goes. But I think it's going to be a great fight. I think we're in store for a good fight.
Well, we've seen the height difference, obviously.
Yeah.
How hard is it going to be, or easy, either way, for Canelo to get inside on that long jab of Kovalev?
I think that's going to be difficult. That's going to be one of the hardest things because, again, he has good range. He's well aware of where he is in the ring at all times. So his jab, pull jab, he keeps perfect distance, I think. So that's one of his strengths. So now Canelo's going to have to try to capitalize on one of Kovalev's strengths. So that's going to be hard to get inside. You know, War was able to do it, but War's a little bigger. So it's going to be, like I said, it's going to be really interesting to see. You know, Canelo's a genius, though, so in the ring anyway. So it's going to be good to see what he does or how they game plan that.
All right, we're getting cut short, Dennis. Thank you, brother.
All right, no problem.